Good Libations, which is our show about mixology. I'm Ethel Andrews, I'm a mixologist, and you will notice that I'm wearing a COVID mask. And this is just by way of reminder that we are living in a serious pandemic and to take the protocols seriously. We want to keep our community safe, and we want to adhere to the social distancing and the wearing of a mask. And this is simply a health issue. We're not trying to take any sort of a stand. But I'm going to remove the mask while we film so that you can hear me unobstructed. But at any rate, it is autumn, and it's finally starting to actually act like autumn. And we're going to make some drinks that are absolutely appropriate for this season of the year, because theoretically it should have been autumn a few weeks ago, but you wouldn't have known it with 100 degree and 90 plus degree temperatures. But now it's getting to be better, like it is the true season. And the drinks that we're going to focus on today are made from Scotch whiskey, which, sad to say, tends to be neglected by people. People tend to think that Scotch is mainly for sipping, and indeed it is if you're drinking a single malt Scotch. But if you're going to drink just regular Scotch, you can make cocktails from it. And not just the Rob Roy and the Rusty Nail. We want to make our scope expand way beyond that and try out other cocktails that are perhaps a bit more innovative and creative. And there are a myriad of them, believe it or not. So we don't want to find ourselves just in that one peg, but we want to get beyond that. And we're going to make several drinks, actually, over a period of time here that incorporate Scotch whiskey. And the first one that I'm going to make is called the Smoking Rose. And there's actually two approaches to this drink. With one approach, you could actually set the sprig of rosemary on fire and get kind of a smoky taste in your glass. But I'm not going to do that here. We don't want to set this studio on fire. But the smoky taste of Scotch itself and the smoky aroma, I think, will suffice to make this drink true to its name. So what we're actually going to do, and this drink incorporates rosemary and a few other ingredients that are quite good and that marry beautifully with Scotch. And I'm going to relocate my mask here out of the way, and then we're going to have at it. And I'm going to take the shaker like I usually do, because this sort of a drink is best shaken over ice, not served in a glass with ice. So what we're going to do is we're going to take some of the rosemary, and we're actually going to muddle it in the bottom of the shaker. And we want a good amount of it, because when you try to muddle something, you have to make sure that there's enough that when you start muddling it, not pulverizing it, but muddling it, that it adheres into the drink and actually blends into it nicely. So I added the Scotch. And again, when we make cocktails, we don't need to use single malt Scotches, because you're going to an excess with that. That is actually meant for sipping. You're better off if you use an ordinary Scotch, but not absolute rot gut. And that way, you're not wasting money needlessly or trying to appear frou-frou when you don't really need to. And another ingredient in this drink is chartreuse liqueur, which is a one-of-a-kind liqueur. And I think I mentioned this before, but it is actually made in small batches by monks at an abbey in France. So this is a one-of-a-kind thing. You cannot substitute it or duplicate it with any other type of liqueur, so don't even try, because you're not going to get the same result out of it. And in addition to that, we're going to add some sugar, or you can use simple syrup if you'd like, if you want to make a batch of simple syrup. And make it yourself. Don't buy commercial simple syrup, because commercial simple syrup has all kinds of additives and junk in it, and we don't need that. So I'm going to add some sugar to this, and I'm going to use kind of a confectioner's sugar, because it dissolves a bit better than regular sugar. And I'm going to add a fairly good amount of it, because otherwise this drink will be a bit too dry. And we don't want to add too much, because then it's going to become sickly sweet and objectionable to most people's palates. So there we go. And now I'm going to start muddling the rosemary in the drink and the chartreuse and the scotch. And if you muddle it in the alcohol, you'll get a much better flavor out of it than if you just muddle it in the bottom by itself or just with the sugar. Because we want to make sure that we get the infusion and the oils from the rosemary so it incorporates beautifully into the alcohol. And now I'm going to add a bit of ice so that we can shake this. And you know, you can have your ice ready in an ice bucket, or you can use anything that will keep the ice from diluting and melting, because if ice starts to melt, it will compromise the quality of the drink and water it down, which we don't want. So I'm going to go ahead and shake it and then disperse it into the glass. And I've actually chosen what you would use as a glass to ordinarily sip straight Scotch whiskey, but I think it's an attractive glass and it suits very well these cocktails. So I'm going to go ahead and dispense it into the glass now and try it out to see if it turned out as it should. And I certainly hope it did. And I'm doing this for tasting purposes, not to serve a whole glass of it. So I'm going to try it out now and see how it turned out. Oh, that is very, very nice. And with this particular cocktail, the chartreuse liqueur actually enhances the smokiness of the scotch with the herbaceous taste that it has in the background. So they each round out each other, and the scotch should be the dominant ingredient, followed by the chartreuse liqueur, which plays off the rosemary, because of course, again, that's an herb and a very fragrant and piquant herb. So very, very nice combination, perfect combination. They all set each other off. And I free poured as I usually do, but keep in mind that the ratio of scotch to chartreuse should be 2 to 1. And then, of course, the rosemary, you should use a fairly generous amount, because you want to make sure that when you muddle it, that you're going to get that distinct flavor of the rosemary in the drink. And again, this drink is called the Smoking Rose, and you can, if you wish, according to the traditional way that it's made, light a sprig of rosemary in the glass that you're going to use. But I thought that might be unwise here. We could set the whole place on fire. And again, keep in mind it's a 2-to-1 ratio of the scotch to the chartreuse. And don't try to substitute the chartreuse, because there is no substitute. Again, it's one of a kind. And as I always like to mention on all my shows, we want to make sure that when we enjoy our alcoholic beverages, that we are safety conscious, that we have a designated driver, and that we keep our community safe and well spoken of by not imbibing too much and being very, very careful, because this isn't just our life, this is the lives of other people also. So let's be responsible and safe. And being that people are kind of in a festive mood in these next few months, you might say, we want to be especially careful. Even though people should be sheltering in place for the most part and not having parties, we still want to be careful about what we drink, because if we do venture out in a car, we don't want to harm others. And thank you again for tuning in to Good Libations, our show about mixology. I'm Ethel Andrews, a mixologist or bartender, and we will see you for the next show. Thank you again. Bye-bye.